FOMO. Sounds like you're cussing someone out. That guy's a real FOMO. But it's not. It's actually a really powerful psychological trigger that makes people buy more. Check out these statistics. Around 69% of millennials experience the phenomenon. And according to Strategy Online, 60% of millennials make reactive purchases because of FOMO. In other words, it's essential to learn how to use FOMO in marketing. So let's look at some FOMO marketing strategies and tactics. Another week, another video. Thanks for tuning back in. In this video, I'm gonna be discussing FOMO, what it is, why to use it, how to use it responsibly, and I'll give you 6 FOMO marketing strategies you can implement on your e-commerce stores. And just so that I won't experience FOMO, why don't you go ahead and like the video and subscribe? It's for a good cause. So, FOMO, what is it? Well, like I said, FOMO stands for the fear of missing out, a psychological trigger humans can't help responding to. According to a study of the phenomenon, FOMO has been defined as a pervasive apprehension that others might be having rewarding experiences from which one is absent. And that kind of hits the nail on the head. FOMO marketing taps into a simple yet primitive desire to be in the action, to be in the know. No one wants to be left out after all. Missing out is a universal fear that goes back thousands of years. To be out of the loop puts a person at odds with the group. Ah, rhymes. It creates social friction and could even be a threat to survival back at one time. So it's easy to see why inclusion is a priority for people. FOMO marketing refers to messaging that appeals to consumers' desire to latch onto every opportunity before it slips through their fingers. Many people would rather make an impulsive purchase than regret failing to act later. The psychology behind FOMO marketing works because we are a risk-averse species. In some cases, avoiding risk means passing up a purchase because we fear putting our money behind something that won't meet our expectations. However, risk avoidance can also mean preventing the possibility of regretting an opportunity. We don't want to put ourselves in that position. Now let's say that you're thinking about buying a car. You have a general idea of what kind of vehicle you want and how much you're willing to spend. Suddenly, you see a Facebook ad announcing a huge promotion at your local dealership. You see the exact car you want. Maybe you hadn't yet committed to a vehicle purchase, but now your FOMO is in high gear. You're afraid of missing out on this chance to save tons of money because it might never present itself again. And that's FOMO marketing. Why should you use FOMO marketing? Well, all of the above. I started out giving you some statistics. Those alone should be enough to get you to use FOMO. There's a huge pool of people just waiting to buy from you. You just have to nudge them in the right direction. And speaking of nudging people, ever hear the expression with great power comes great responsibility? Unless you've been living under a rock, of course you have. That quote can be easily applied to FOMO marketing. FOMO marketing should be used responsibly. The thing about FOMO is that its impact lies largely in its ability to trigger negative emotions. Feeling like you're missing out can create a real sense of unease for people. So you need to have the right intention when formulating your approach. You have to be honest with your audience and create offers that resonate with them. If you're disingenuous about your offers, consumers will smell the duplicity a mile away. For instance, if you say you're only offering a discount code to your email subscribers, you can broadcast that code or a similar one over social media a few days later. Today's consumers are smart and savvy and can usually sense whenever a brand is trying to deceive or manipulate them. Being over the top with FOMO marketing, where you try to deliberately trigger unpleasant emotions, can end up backfiring and drive a wedge between you and your customers. So you need to use it correctly. How? Well, so glad you asked. Here's six FOMO marketing strategies you can implement right now. Number one, set a time limit. Setting a deadline is critical for FOMO marketing. We're conditioned to respect deadlines right from our childhood, and this puts us under pressure. This stands true when we're making purchase decisions as the time is ticking away. For this reason, we end up making impulsive purchases. However, do keep in mind that the deadline that you set has to be absolute. If you keep extending it, your customers will get used to the fact that the deal will be available after the expiry too. At the same time, this can hurt your brand reputation because you're not abiding by your word. Amazon uses this form of marketing exceptionally well. They put up deal of the day offers which last 24 hours. To claim the deal, you need to purchase it within that duration. FOMO strategy number two, leverage good copywriting. Language matters a lot when it comes to FOMO marketing. You want your audience to feel as though time is running out and that they're about to lose on an amazing offer. When crafting your marketing material, use strong verbs and adjectives to instill FOMO in your target audience. Phrases like "don't miss this" and "while supplies last" are good examples. But you can get a bit more creative. You'll kick yourself if the hourglass is almost empty on your opportunity to halt. You'll want to hear this. Craving some so-and-so? Now's your chance.
Supreme sales Sundays.
You get the idea. Your goal is to send the message that if your audience doesn't act now, they'll regret their decision. Think about your target audience when you're designing your FOMO message. For example, if you're marketing to people who love gaming, use gaming jargon to communicate your offer. Number three, leverage social proof. Social proof is one of the most tried and true marketing techniques of all time. It relies on a very simple premise of having current customers validate your product or brand, and it factors heavily in the overall FOMO strategy. However, you need to understand when to use it for maximum impact. Ideally, it should be used at the end of the purchase funnel, when consumers are about to make a purchase decision. Sometimes, social proof is all that people need to make a purchase. A great way of doing this is by posting and sharing testimonials on your social media posts from your existing customers. When people read positive experiences other consumers have had with your brand, they'll be more likely to purchase from you. Similarly, you can use social proof notification tools to show who is purchasing from you currently. If your website visitors know that others are buying from you, they'll want to purchase from you too. At the end of the day, strong social proof lets prospects know that other people are already using your product and they couldn't be happier about it. Therefore, prospects should take action so they don't miss out on the benefits. FOMO strategy number four, highlight missed opportunities. To give a bigger boost to FOMO marketing, you should consider showcasing all the opportunities that were missed by your customers. When they notice that they've lost a good deal just because they were late or didn't make a call quickly, they'll start becoming anxious. This anxiety is nothing but FOMO, and it can push them to make their decisions quickly so that they don't miss out on other deals. Sometimes, this is all that's required to push them over the edge. Booking.com uses this strategy to their advantage. Note how they're leveraging FOMO by using the phrase, "you missed it." Number five, show stock levels. Scarcity is a big component of FOMO marketing because if something is about to run out, there is a huge incentive to get it now. There are many ways to highlight scarcity. For example, if you're running an online store, you can show stock levels as Amazon does. Or if you're in the travel business, you could show the number of spaces left as Booking.com. And you can ramp up the FOMO advertising with while stock last messaging that suggests that your product or service is about to run out or disappear entirely. And strategy number six, create a special offer with a deadline. We already talked about the ticking clock, but we were focused mostly on discounts. You can also use deadlines and FOMO marketing to give your customers other advantages if they shop with you. For instance, maybe you'll offer free shipping during the month of May. On June 1st, the deal goes away, so your target audience needs to start shopping now. You could also offer a free bonus with every purchase if consumers buy before the deadline, such as a downloadable product or a gift with purchase. People experience FOMO when they know they could get something for free that would otherwise cost them money. And just because I'm a nice guy, here's your bonus tip. Use exclusivity. As humans, we love exclusive offers. There's something about having access to discounts and deals that others don't that gets our blood pumping. It makes us feel special. So it's not surprising that exclusivity is a big part of FOMO marketing. Creating offers and positioning products in a way that only certain people can access them can have a huge impact. Take this promotion for example. Besides earning a 15% off coupon, those who sign up will receive exclusive offers as well. In addition to overcoming the fear of missing out, this can instill a sense of loyalty in many customers. They'll be grateful that you've given them perks that the general public doesn't have access to, which can be a big selling point. And there you have it, 7 FOMO marketing strategies that you can use to grow your profits. Use them wisely. Of course, there are other methods like recent sales notifications, card reserve timers, and so on. But we believe the 7 that I mentioned are the most important ones. If you have a Shopify store and want to implement any of these, look no further than Vitals. With 40 plus apps in one, you'll get everything you need to employ FOMO. Product bundles, countdown timer, stock scarcity, pop-ups, announcement bars, recent sales notification, product reviews, and so much more. Plus, you can try it free for 30 days. With that, get cracking and use FOMO wisely, my young Padawans. Thanks for watching and thumbing up the video. Subscribe and I'll see you in the next one.